Hi everyone, welcome to the first episode in our Research Essentials series for secondary students. So this tutorial series is going to give you practical tips and tricks for finding reliable information online. Before we get into the nitty-gritty of today's episode, I just want to touch on why this topic is so important. It's so challenging right now to be able to discern what's actually true and what's not. There is so much information out there, it's really hard to find the good stuff, especially find it quickly. We've got Facebook, we've got Instagram, we've got all these different places where people can post their opinions, they can make their own website. We need to be able to tell whether the people that are posting the information should be trusted or not. When we go searching, we get an assignment from our teacher or we want to find some information, there's lots of different things that are going to come up. One of the things we see a lot is satirical news. So this is news that's actually poking fun at something that's happening. So this is an example here. We've got another example here. Packs of awkward teenagers lurking outside cinema suggests it's school holidays. So it's actually a joke. In this example, it's obvious that it's a joke, but there are times where satirical news can be pretty hard to tell whether it's a joke or whether it's true. And if you don't know too much about a specific topic, you might be fooled into thinking that the satirical news article is actually giving you reliable information. We've also got things like clickbait. So in this example, British scientists clone dinosaur. That's not actually a dinosaur, it's a kangaroo. The other example I've got here is this man about to get eaten by a shark. Clickbait, he's actually shark bait, it should be called. It's photoshopped. When you clicked on it, you went through to an advertisement and the advertisers got money. So with all this information flying around, it can be hard to cut through and get to the stuff that's actually reliable. And that's what this series is going to show you how to do. So let's get started on today's episode, which goes over our top three tips for searching online. Let's get started. So let's imagine you've been given an assignment from your teacher. Was Ned Kelly a hero? Why? Why not? This is a complex question inviting a complex response. Now be honest, where's the first place you would go to start your research? Starts with G and ends in Google? That's right, Google. So there are a couple of limitations to Google. It can only show you what it knows of the web. So I used to think that Google was the entirety of the internet. It's actually not. Not all sites are reliable. Unless you use precise keywords, you're going to get millions of irrelevant pages. So it's really important that I use precise keywords. If I type in, was Ned Kelly a hero? Why not? I'm going to get 11 million results. That's because Google is going to search every single word. It's going to search was, ah, why not? It's going to confuse Google. So if we think about that topic, our actual keywords are just Ned Kelly, just the two most important words. So we type in Ned Kelly. Let's see how many results we get. We've got 29.9 million results. That's because the Google search is searching for every website that has the word Ned and every website that has the word Kelly. But if I put it in quotation marks, it's going to only search web pages where these two names appear next to each other. So that means that I'm going to eliminate millions of unnecessary pages. So now I've only got 2.3 million results, which is a start. One of the first web pages that comes up is Wikipedia. Wikipedia is a bit of a contentious one. It's good in some ways and not so good in others. So it's good in that it can give you a bit of an overview of your topic, but you cannot use Wikipedia as a reference for your assignments because the information can be edited, which means it can be unreliable. If you click on one of these footnotes and go down the bottom, some of these resources can be really good at the bottom of the Wikipedia page. Let's say I want to find something specific just to get my head around something to do with Ned Kelly, maybe his mother. I can use this little trick called Control F or Command F if you're on a Mac. So I can do Control F and I can type mother. And I can see that the name mother appears 24 times. So if I go down, I can find all the places where they talk about Ned Kelly's mother. And I can just find out more about that. I could do family and so on. And you can do this with any web pages that you come across. It's not just Wikipedia. So that Control F trick is a great way to get to the information you need more quickly. So you need to use keywords. Use the quotation marks to hone down your results and use the Control F trick to find a keyword once you're on a document and you're looking through information. So they're the three top tips for today, and I hope to see you next week when we delve more deeply into how to analyze and find reliable websites. Thanks everyone.